I'm such that spy for you. I do that 3-4 times again. I testify for you. I'm told I like you. That I do it all and I'm all wrong. You're scared to do. I'm not. As long as you joking, now in for me. I ain't got it.
Hey guys, it's your girl Paradise. What's up, y'all? It's your girl Paradise. If you're new and if you're returning, you already know what it do. So this probably, I keep on saying this when I record, but this probably gonna be my first video on YouTube that y'all gonna see, because I be recording stuff and never uploading it. But y'all, today is Friday. I've been on vacation from my 9 to 5 for a whole week. I go back on Monday and I haven't done nothing. Like, I slept, I relaxed, I didn't really stress out too much. I do a couple things because I help take care of my mom. That's a whole nother situation, a whole nother story, or a whole nother day. But I do other little things here and there, but like, I was tired, okay? So I didn't do nothing. So with that being said, my vacation is already over and I have things I want to accomplish, okay? Like, I was supposed to edit my YouTube, because I have an old YouTube channel, so I'm thinking that you guys will see this on my old channel. I'm going to like archive all my old stuff and just like start afresh. There's no reason for me to start a whole new channel, I'm thinking in my head, you know? So that, I have a business that I just kind of like, it's kind of on the back burner. I still sell products, it's lashes, Lash Out Beauty LA. The Instagram will be linked in this video, but my website is not up anymore. I need stuff for my packaging and I just want to get that back going again because I really enjoy doing it. And like I said, I enjoy doing YouTube. I don't care about being famous or none of that stuff. I just like to record stuff, so I'm going to post it. Okay. Also, I didn't get my hair done. I had some braids and I took it out and I just been having my hair in this ponytail. So I'm thinking I might do a silk press. And yeah, I need labels from Avery for my lashes, and just, it's crazy, y'all. And I want to do a vision board, so I do monthly vision boards. It helps me keep track with what I'm doing instead of like a yearly one. So I want to do that. So I'm going to get on Pinterest and I'm going to find some stuff that represents what the goals are. And of course, I'm going to break it down in my planner or in a notebook or whatever. But I do want to go and pick up those so I can kind of have that little vision board type of vibe for myself to just like stay on track monthly. And girl, I got dressed today. Like, you know how you really don't be looking at yourself for real? Girl, I really let myself go. All this is stomach. Okay, let me push this back some, because y'all don't understand. Y'all don't understand. Okay, look, I'm really being for real. Like, this is stomach. Like, I have a round stomach. And this ass is not giving the ass that it used to give. You know what I'm saying?
So anyway,
yeah, it's just not giving what it needs to give. I'm not confident a lot of times lately when I put on my clothes. This ass is still kind of fat, though. You know, I just need a little shaping. And I was about to go and get a whole tummy tuck, but I'm like, girl, at the end of the day, the gym, because mentally, your girl be, my brain. So the gym, it does so much more for you than just physical. I'm not really tripping about the physical. I do want to, you know, get it together, but it's more about like having that consistency, you know what I mean? And just taking control of things. Like, the gym trickles down to a lot of things that you are dealing with, like mentally and all that stuff like that. So I'm just gonna do that instead of, I mean, that tummy tuck is still on the table. It's still on the table. My husband, I got married, y'all. If y'all seen, I don't know if I still have my old videos up or not, but I got married. My husband told me, you ain't getting that shit. You ain't getting a tummy tuck. So I mean, now look at me. I gotta listen. I got a whole husband that I gotta listen. He like, is that worth your life? And I'm like, a little bit. You know what I'm saying? But it's crazy. I'll get into that whole story about me getting married and all that stuff like that, because I know y'all don't know jack. This is probably y'all first time seeing me, but I just feel so, don't y'all see how comfortable I feel? So yeah, just get into it. Anyway, I don't think I'm ever gonna post him, because a private life is a happy life, but y'all probably will see him or hear him or hear of him a lot. But yeah, my son is up in the living room too. Jeremiah,
yeah,
come here Russ, real quick.
to win. Where have you been?
Don't you look just like me? Look.
Twin, where have you been? Nobody knows me.
Nobody
knows
me.
Okay, I just want
to... Let me try again. And let me make the speech at the end of the video. Okay, do it.
Nobody knows me like you do. Yeah. Nobody don't love me quite like you.
You let me make this speech.
Okay. Anyways, I just want y'all to see him. But anyway, I'm going to get into doing some stuff. I got my iPad charger. I'm going to set that up. I have my MacBook charging so I can edit my YouTube video, whatever. And then I'm going to go next door and try to take my mom stay next door to me. I'm going to go next door and try to take care of her real quick so I can get into the day. So I just want to come and introduce the vlog. Hey, girl. Hey, girl.
Yes. Can I introduce myself and what I like?
Go ahead.
Hello, my name is Jeremiah and I like...
Cut off. Would you say you like Sonic and what else?
I was going to say I like Sonic and how do you get those Sonic split mouth Sonic plushies and the classic Eggman plushie and those animal plushies. So
My son is only 9. He about to be so tall. Like I know I'm pretty short, but don't stand on your tips. Don't play with the kid. Stop. Don't stand on your tips. Like you're taller. Boy, get on. He got like 2 inches in it. That's it. Okay, so anyway, I just want y'all to see him because y'all probably never seen him before. Like I said, this is probably y'all first time seeing me. So if this your first time seeing me, you like the NIG, then go ahead and subscribe. Why not? And I'm gonna post my Instagram down there because I'm about to start posting on there.
And make sure you include me too.
Okay, I'll include you. We a package deal. He don't have an Instagram. What?
I'm trying to...
I'll be back, y'all. Guys, so I'm back. It been so much going on, y'all, but I'm back and I don't know why. I think because I'm overthinking or whatever. I end up just like sitting at my desk and I was supposed to be editing, but I end up cleaning out my drawers and everything. So I cleaned out all the drawers in my desk and I have like, this used to be a workstation, but it just basically turned into a beauty desk. So yeah, I just had a whole bunch of products and stuff. It's a lot of stuff that I gotta like get rid of, you know, like when you're cleaning up and you're like pretty much done, but it's all those little scattered things that you have no idea where to put it. I'm about to just throw it away because I'm getting overwhelmed because like I'm done, but where am I putting this stuff? Like all these extra scissors, why do I need 4, 5, 6 pairs of scissors? I don't know. I just feel like I lose scissors and then I just buy more scissors because this is 2 over here. I have 2 in my kitchen and then I got 4 in my bathroom. Like why do you have so many scissors? I don't know. Okay. Then I have a lot of stuff that I bought, like pills and stuff like that, that are expired because I be stocking up on stuff and then not staying consistent with them. So, girl, we get our life together, okay? My pills, I need to be having them, like my vitamins and whatever else that I'm doing for nutrition needs to be sitting out. So, I'm about to go on Amazon and get like an aesthetic one because that's why I be putting stuff away. If it's not, I don't really too much like normal packaging of anything. So if it's not aesthetic, I'm putting it in a drawer. And when I put it in a drawer, guess what we're going to do? Forget. We're going to forget about it. So anyway, I'm going to go on Amazon and get like some aesthetic stuff. Because I work from home, guys. And like, I never sit at my desk. I be in the bed with my laptop half-assed. Like, you know, I need to just come to my desk. My pills right here. My water. Like, you know, get it. My at-home girl aesthetic together. Because it ain't giving. I even took the computers off my desk. All I use is a laptop. So I'm like literally doing risk management, fraud protection, all stuff from just my laptop. So it'll be like mass screens. Then I'll be stressed out all day. But I'm sick of looking at the computer on my desk. Because my room is just cream, whatever. And they get these big black computers. And I'm like, nope. Don't go with the vibe. Okay? But anyway, so I'm about to just get rid of all this junk. Like, why did I get this? What I'm gonna do with this little tiny mirror? Hey guys, it's the next day. I ended up, yesterday was my mom's birthday. I did decorate a little bit over there and I just chilled. It was going by too quick and nothing didn't go according to plan. What's that on my shirt? Nothing didn't go according to my plan. I didn't pick up the camera at all. It was just too much, okay? right now I'm getting ready to go to my nail appointment. It's like 3 something, and my nail appointment is at 5. This is what my nails are looking like right now. They are so sick. I actually really love my nails right now. And girl, it's been 2 weeks. They are barely grown out, but I already pre-booked my nail appointment, so I got to go. All right, so today, y'all, did y'all know that y'all can order Sephora on DoorDash? Did y'all know that? I ordered my Sephora on DoorDash. So I'm excited. So I just ordered topicals. I just needed the eye patches. And then I wanted to try the topicals brightening and clearing serum, because I have some hyperpigmentation on my face. I got foundation today, so you can't see it. And I just really been wanting to try these things. Now this right here, I read the reviews on this. And the spray, they say it stank real bad. So we gonna see what it's giving. And then I also got a package in today from Yeti. So package, I turned it the opposite way because obviously my address is on there. So I'm getting ready to open this and see what it's giving. Now I did, this is my second time getting something from Yeti. If, 1 second. So I used to do the fitness and stuff for Yeti, like about 2 years ago. They had certain influencers come in before certain launch and just kind of like, you know, get to see what's new and try it on and get to know, you know, how we feel about them, whatever like that. But I thought I knew my size because I've already did fittings with them. But girl, no, wasn't nothing fitting when I got it. It just wasn't given. So anyway, I got my package. It was real quick for me to return it at a drop-off location, and literally got my package the next day. They was not playing. So I did get my stuff. So I did get some high-waisted thongs, because girl, I be trying to wear some dresses and the stomach don't be giving, but you still want that ass to be fat, you feel me? So this is a high-waisted shaping thong, nearly naked shaping high-waisted thong for $34.95. It's giving. It's giving. It's gonna suck you in. My only problem that I can foresee is if it suck you in so much, you gonna look like you got a big back. But you know, that's just the price you pay. And then I got another one in 10, because just depending on what I have on, high waisted, I don't know, I just felt like you needed a 10 too. And I think I got brown also, same price, same shebang. Then I got, and that's the same price obviously, this was $59.99. It is the nearly naked shaping plunge bra, and I'm most excited for this because my titties, girl, they just too big. Like, I'm not trying to be one of those people that want to go under the knife and just get everything changed by myself, but these titties is so fucking huge. One titty is about the size of my head. They heavy and they hurt my back, and his stomach is big, and his back is getting big too. I'm still cute as fuck, don't get it wrong. Don't get it twisted. But anyway, look at this bra. Look how stretchy it is. And then like the back, I like the fact that the bra strap, like it's not like a thin strap. So if you got them back rolls, it's gonna, you know, it's gonna give. So I'm thinking both of them together might smooth your girl out. Oh, I was excited about this. This is the nearly naked shaping thong bodysuit. Okay. It's $64.95, and I just figured I'm working on myself, whatever, wear something that's gonna be sucking me in, you know, still cute, wear around the house or under something. But girl, who is this fitting? Who's, and I ordered a 5X in this because I'm like, the 1X wasn't given, so let me just size, because it was like this big. Okay, so I'm scared of this, because but I'm most excited for this. Like, I really want to see. And then like, who's titty fitting in? But okay, now I'm pretty sure I got the same thing in black, because why would you get black? Yeah, $64.99, it's the same thing. Same thing in black. I've been trying to detangle my hair for over 30 minutes, and I'm not having too much luck. I mean, it's okay, but I'm really struggling, y'all, and it's just not okay. I always wait too long without combing out my hair, and then it dreads up. It dreads up.
I'm kind of scared there could be like shards of glass in it, so I'm not gonna drink it. I guess we're just gonna throw the straw away. Okay, so this was the last stop. So I stopped at Whole Foods.
Like, it just, oh my god. And the whole thing is, I ain't never get to this side.
And then they said I had a
It's literally dreaded. Okay? Dreaded. Now I gotta do the other side. I mean, look at this. I be having hair. It sheds. It's just too fucking much, okay? It's really too fucking much for me. What do y'all use? If y'all got curly hair, what do y'all use to detangle with? I feel like stuff don't have enough slip. What do y'all use to detangle y'all's hair? I'll be back when it's done. Don't believe me when I said dread. Look. Look. Do y'all look? That's what I'm talking about. That's what I'm talking about. And I don't have nobody blame but myself. Cause why you ain't comb your hair? I'll be back. Y'all, I plugged in my. Don't mind my voice. I plugged in my. I ain't got no case. I do got some case numbers and stuff showing in there. You can't see it. Yeah, you can't see it. But anyway, I use this blow dryer, this Revlon blow dryer. I really want the round one so I can give myself some body. I feel like it'll eat. Because if my hair look like this already from just the products that I use and this, I use a Briogeo Don't Despair Repair shampoo and conditioner. And then I use Mielle leave-in conditioner, and then I just use this Garnier Fructis. It's the anti-frizz, the Sleek and Shine anti-frizz serum. I like this because it's very lightweight. It don't weigh down my hair, and I'm about to put some more up in here too. And I just kind of really on the ends, y'all, because I need another trim slash cut. I just kind of don't like the way my ends look. And they don't look bad, but they don't look how I want them. So anyway, I'm about to go over my hair a little bit with this. This is the Conair Pro. I think it's the Remington. It's ate up, girl. I have so many other flat irons, but I keep going back to that one because it just does the job so quick, so effortlessly, so seamlessly. So I'm just going to grab like all this in the front. You see how it's not, I guess I didn't really wrap it right. Make sure you be careful with y'all ends, y'all. I should be using a bigger comb, too. So I'm just going to go over this a little bit. I don't know why I do that every time I'm using a flat iron. Look at that. One swipe. Good to go. I think I'm going to do my hair like this for now on instead of doing like a real... Because my hair is pretty like thin as I've gotten older. And I think stress is just taking my hair out. So if you guys know a really good vitamin that helps, some vitamins that specialize in like thickening your hair, let me know, because my hair used to be really, really thick to where like my mom couldn't even put my hair in one ponytail. She used to have to like split it up. But yeah, I'm definitely interested in trying to grow my hair too, but really just overall health and thickness. But look how much better that looks than this. I said, it's eating. You would think I did some type of some kind of pressing or something. So just going over this lightly. I really feel like this is a waste of the heat. I might actually leave my hair alone to my birthday now since I'm doing this. Because I don't want to just waste the heat and then put a whole like wig on my hair for real. I don't know what to do. I'm always like not knowing what to do to my hair, really. But I'm gonna just do this real quick. So before I leave, I always have to like check on my mom, make sure she has what she needs. before I get out, because y'all know I told y'all I'll take care of her right now. She's doing so much better though. She's making a lot of progress. So I'm going to do these edges real quick. I'm gonna move y'all so y'all could try to see how I'm doing my edges. It's not much. I just like it to look like something, because it ain't looking like nothing. So I'm gonna move y'all so y'all can see how I'm doing my edges, and then we gonna get out of here. All right, so let's see, I'm just using the mini edge fixer. I like these little mini ones. It's easy for me to, I don't know, keep up with, and I feel like it stay fresher for longer. Like, you know how you had the other one for too long and it started getting like whitish in the container? I don't like that. So I'm just gonna kind of, I just kind of do a little something. I don't do too much. I don't never do too much. I never really needed to be honest. Yeah. But yeah. So I always brush these parts down. It's like my staple. No matter if I have a ponytail, braid, whatever, this is pretty much what I do. Then I make sure I get my little sideburns. I love a good sideburn, honey. And then I just kind of, you know, spruce that up a little bit. Can y'all see? Like I said, I'm not doing much. I just want it to look like that's better than inside. You see what I mean? Just a little sleek. A little sleeky sleek. I know me do it around the back too, because them little kitchens, sometimes they be looking a little eerie. I ain't really liking this one. Like, I did a little too much. It's all right. I'm going to fix that one because I don't like the... I probably shouldn't even show y'all this because I'm in such a rush that I'm not even doing it right. I'm not rushing because my appointment is at 1. But... pretty much done. I just put a little bit more of this Garnier Fructisse in it just to give me some little, you know, little razzle dazzle, make sure it's like shiny. And I'm about to take a little picture of this so I could probably use it in my thumbnail. And yeah, I'm gonna go take care of my mom real quick and I'm gonna get out of this house. So I will see y'all when I am either in the car or at the nail salon. Decided to just throw some curls in there a little bit. I wasn't liking how the ends was looking and stuff without me actually really straightening it. So I'm just going, that's just always a way that you can finesse is curls. Much, much better. I really need my bigger comb because, you know, rule number one is not to detangle with no damn rat tail comb, but. Should I split this into two? Look at that. It's crazy because I'm using the camera to look at what I'm doing. I'm not even looking at my mirror. But yeah, I'm almost done. It just looks so much better, honestly. I don't know what I thought I was doing. But this is still better than a whole silk press, honestly. Oh, yeah. I feel much better about life.
Got me crisscross, fall back, fall back. Told you from the jump, jump, I can do bad, bad, bad.